take these. And let's look around. Well, south is where he came from. This is a long, large room. Carter at the end. Yeah, just mapping it out. Okay. Yeah, we'll follow it around. I could look for hidden walls and stuff, but we'll just map it out normally first. Yeah, I was expecting the monster thing to light up any second now. It's hilarious how these things get stuck behind pillars like that. Oh my god, there's so many of them. Alright. Could be tricky. On the other hand, we're really going to be using our whirlwind to great effect. You know what? I'm a little nervous here. Let's heal Nelvin. Small healing. Because they don't like when they start throwing. That's the wrong person. They don't like when you start throwing whirlwind at them. It doesn't really endear them to him, I don't think. Critical hit, Valden, nice! 120 points, I think that was, it said. 120 something, I'm pretty sure it said 120. That really helps. As does this. God, I love those critical hits. Wind Devil spell. Okay. They're targeting. They're targeting Selena. Ouch. Well, she deflected that one. Edgel deflected. Edgel doing nicely. Okay, well, we're gonna heal Selena now. Small healing should do it. Not a lot of hit points that she needs. 33. Whirlwind again. And I guess Citrine will just defend here, because you can't reach anybody. How sad. Nice. Healed. We'll move up and attack, of course. When we get a chance to. Wind Devil on. Okay, well then, I guess. There's Valden, right? Yeah. We advance and destroy. Whirlwind again. I guess we'll rest after this again. I'll create food. I don't think we have to buy food anymore. I think one more round of Whirlwind alone would just kill these guys off. Windheller on. Loading again. He can take it. Alright, just making sure she still does have her weapon. Yes, she does. Whirlwind again. So yeah, I'm dealing these whirlwind might kill. And oh yeah. They've gotta have very little hit points at this point. I'm not even gonna bother wasting the spell on them. $225 experience. Can't carry any of these. Yeah, it's a shame. We're gonna rest up against this wall here. So, we have no food. I will create the food. Or not, because I have so little hit points. Oh, that's a problem. Wait, we have no food at all. Aw, man. I'm gonna have to take a magic potion to give myself enough magic points so I can create food. You know, I'm surprised it's not a cleric spell too. Maybe it could. Probably not. It's gonna be an alchemist spell because adventure is a cross between warrior and alchemist, so it's an alchemy spell. And I think ranger is warrior and mystic, I think. Not completely sure, but in any case, we don't have food. So I have to give myself magic points so that we can give ourselves food so that we can give ourselves more magic points. I mean, Valda needs a little bit of healing too, so there's that. It's just because mostly. Because my used magic is at 75%, so I can fail sometimes. And if it's a spell with a lot of mana, that mana gets used whether you are successful in casting it or not. It's one feature I really don't like. So, let's hope I actually have one of them. Okay, spell points 3. I'm just gonna move this stuff over. I don't like when there's an empty space like that. Spell points 3? 5? No. Alright, we're gonna use 3. I would have used a smaller one, but that's the smallest we have available. Alright, so now... she only needs one. But I'm gonna cast two, because we can't cast it for certain people. It's gonna be create food for everybody. So Nelvin needs two rests. So create food. Bling! And then... bling! Or fail. Bling! Fail. Oh god. Okay, I guess we're resting once. Or... this is interesting, isn't it? No. Okay, now hopefully we can succeed in creating food so that Citrine and Nelvin can rest again and get up to full. Great food. Great food, thank you. That doesn't even get her at full. Look at that. She's still got more. Because she's wasting it on failed create food spells. Well, I can't do that yet. Very complicated system they set up here. Actually, it's not that complicated. It's just things to remember. Certain orders you have to do things in. So what I should first do, then, is create food for everybody. And then fail. Okay. So now, we'll do the magical lantern. And now we'll do the magical barrier. Now we'll do the magical assault, failing. Failing. And failing. Okay. At least we all have food. I mean, I could try it again. Well, let's just go as it is. Before something horrible happens, let's save. Because I really don't want to do that all over again. Door. Beyond the door lies the ultimate unspeakable horror of the universe. You know, I don't like that back there. Wait, there's more though, right? No, north. Why am I... I gotta turn around or something. I just want to make sure there's nothing here. Alright. You know why I got turned around? Because I thought the door was in the... south wall. Look at that. It's not advancing, and the monster thing is not lighting up. Look what we have over there as well. Am I not, like, in the room? Ha Are you real? Okay. You see the opening to a narrow passage flanked by powerful stone statues. Some gargoyles are just preparing to fly through the passage when suddenly the statues come to life. For a moment, you see nothing but leather thongs and wild stone fists flying all around. Then the statues become motionless again, and the remains of the gargoyles lie on the floor between them. That's awesome. You killed the gargoyles. Any reason exactly? Poke. Okay. I cannot interact with you. You very cautiously approach the corridor between the statues. No, I wasn't. I approached the statue itself. When you're almost past them, a red light flashes in the eyes of the statues, and they suddenly attack you with a loud grinding sound and astonishing speed. Now hopefully you can actually fight them and not just get pulverized in text. Like the gargoyles did. Okay, we'll be fighting stone golems. Four of them. Now, if there are any things like the stone or granite golems we fought before, they attack with fists, obviously, and, like earthquake spells and, like, basically falling rock kind of spells. Avalanche, it's called. I hate that I only have my shield up, it's so annoying. Should I take one? It's using valuable, well, not only resources, but... Healing Potion 4. Yeah, I think I'll have her... No, not Healing Potion. Spell Points 3. On, Citrine. Now, technically, you think wind wouldn't do much to a rock. I mean, it does over time erodes, but we want, like, instant gratification. But let's see. It might do something, a whirlwind. Alright, so... Yeah, good. Spell points. So I'll try to get those protections up. Starting next round. Whirlwind, how's it do? 21? Okay, that's pretty good. I figured it wouldn't affect them much at all. Now these things have a lot of hit points. Nine points of damage, agile 3. Mudsling. Only 4, okay. Mudsling again. Deflected. Well, if they only throw mudsling spells, we're completely fine. Whirlwind. Okay, so I try to get this up. Magical assault for better weapon efficiency. Oh, wow. These things aren't that tough. Oh, nice. These are the granite golems I'm thinking of that were really hard. These are, like, fine. They're just throwing mudslings at us and stuff. We do have the thing up, though. And you never know. This might not even be the final enemy, so... Let's try to get our anti-magic wall up anyway. I can't even attack at this point, so it's just as well. Let's throw a Wind Howler at this one. Actually, I'll throw it at this one. Nice. That was a good call. Nice, wow. And we got a bunch of rocks. We don't need that. What monster? Okay. We were seeing two, but it was two groups. Alright. Round two. Now we have... I didn't get this up, did I? Anti-magic wall? Okay. Use those arrows, because we can't carry them. Did that work? I think it worked. The anti-magic wall. Five damage. Six damage, mudsling. Alright, we've got all the protections up. Chain can once again start whacking things. Whirlwind again. One down. Two down. We can advance. I'm gonna stop using spells. Already damaged by two rounds of whirlwinds as it is. 30 damage, nice. Sweet. Nelvin, level 24, nice. 106 total life points, 385 total power points. 31 spell learning points and 93 training points. We gotta get him some training. And something. Yay! Should I throw in a quick save? Yes, I should. Alright, where are we? Oh, right. Okay. So we're trying to make our way into this area, to the north? Which is over here? So, they were really guarding this, which I'm guessing is a illusory wall, because I don't see anything here. Were they? Give me a second. There's something in there. There must be a button. They're guarding it, obviously. Okay. I'm meaning to turn, and I'm pressing, like, strafe. Where is the button? A button. I'm poking it. I'm poking at nothing. Maybe the button's outside somewhere? There's gotta be something. I mean, they're guarding it. There's a space there. The only problem is trying to find a button shape on these pixelated walls. Unless I just pass through the wall on the other side of it, but that wouldn't make much sense, would it? Because they're guarding that area. This is that box? Yeah. There's a box. Something's gotta be inside it. What's in the box? Come on, what's in the box, man? What's in the box? We are not getting through into the box. At least not this way. How annoying. Well, I'm back to looking for a button. Because after all, it was a button that I thought I couldn't get off that floor. These are windows? I don't even know. Oh, button. Moving around here somewhere. Something. There's gotta be something in there. Unless they're just trying to torture us, like a MacGuffin entrance that doesn't exist. Oops. This is like the ultimate reason to go up, unless behind the stair, behind the wall that we can't get through is another set of stairs. Could be, but we can't find our way through there, so the point is kind of moot unless we can find some kind of switch, button, something. You'd think it would be in that room. Especially the fact that I can't find anything out here. Maybe. Oh, wait. Is that a. I thought I saw a tiny. No. Little rock. It's not that, right? That's like something you'd find in Eye of the Beholder. I haven't seen tiny little switches like that in this game yet, I don't think. What's so annoying? We got past all of your defenders. Oh. Only to be thwarted. Yet again. Maybe we need to search for something. Who's got a good search skill? 65? 95 Alden. Yeah, he is a ranger, like a hunter type. So you just need to wander around and find a random thing. Did happen once in Amber Star. I think it was a key in Amber Star that you needed a character with a good search skill to find the key on the ground or something. This is actually really annoying. I know there's something in there. Unless it's something ridiculous, like I have to take a levitate up to get in there. Let's look out here for a sec. Don't see any button. I just see stairs. Well, I don't want to give up on this. Maybe on one of the pillars, but never seen that. Never seen anything on a pillar before. I don't understand. I'll keep him. Forward. Look at the wrong thing. Okay. I'm gonna mess around and search around here some more off screen. It must be boring seeing me just walk all around. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna try to find my way into what it's gotta be something. Something in here. So annoying. Unless there's a secret wall on the other side. Stand by for a second. I'm not signing off just yet. I'll see if there's a secret wall through here. Where am I? I didn't go through anything, right? I went out. Yeah, continuing on this wall. Wait, there's a monster! We found our way through somewhere.